We get asked every day, when is the right time for me to downsize and consider moving to a smaller home? Well, today we're going to address that with our three W's of downsizing. I'm Scott.
And I'm Lane. Think three W. Three Absolutely. W.
And welcome to the Orange County Real Estate Beat. So all of our clients these days, so many of them are the baby boomer generation, where they're thinking it's time to downsize. And we want to help with that dilemma with the three W's, the where, the what, and the when. Lane, why don't you start with the where?
Where, yeah. Where are you going to go? Are you going to stay local? Are you going to buy, like, well, for a lot of our clients, they sell their five-bedroom pool house that they raised their families in, and then they're buying a small condo, and they're staying locally. Some of their retirement dollar goes a lot further in areas maybe outside of Orange County. So you have to make that determination of where do you want to be? What's the long-term goal? What's beneficial for your family? Sometimes, for at least the millennial generation, it's really hard to be able to afford a home in Orange County that they're starting out of state.
They're starting out.
And even if the parents don't necessarily have to sell their house to retire out there, they're still following their family because that's the right thing
Absolutely.
To do.
Absolutely. Yep, you bet. And tying in with that, where then is kind of another two-pronged situation with that is a lot of our baby boomer clients are saying, we want to go where our children are, grandchildren are. Some are saying, we want to go where the weather's a little bit different, where it's sunnier, where we have more golf opportunities, tennis opportunities, whatever. So you need to be thinking, first and foremost, get your vision boards out, start writing, think about where you want to go. Lane, what's next?
I believe it is when? Is it when?
When or what? It doesn't matter.
When or what? Okay, let's do when then.
Absolutely.
Because that's another thing that when you take your vision boards and you're visualizing yourself out there, you want to think of when you plan on going. So that's a big, important W as well.
Exactly. And Lane, you know, a lot of people say, when I retire, I'm going to make that move to downsize to the wheres that we just previously talked about. But we're starting to see people playing it forward a little bit on that when, aren't we?
Yeah, so we're starting to see a lot of homeowners actually, or future retirees, buying their next forever home, you know, even if it's out of state earlier than where they anticipated because of, you know, unfortunately, the fortunate circumstances that happened with COVID, it put a lot of people being in the opportunity or circumstances of working from home.
Yeah.
So now if you're able to work from remote, a lot of our baby boomers, even if they're still working their last final 2 years before retirement, are getting their retirement homes now because one, they want to get ahead of increase in home prices and an increase in interest rates. So it's actually beneficial for them to save money in the long term to get that retirement home early.
No, absolutely. So those are two things we want to be thinking about. Where do you want to go? And when are you going to be going? And then our last W with this of the three is the what?
Exactly.
And you want to be determining what is it that you actually want in the next home. We find, especially in households with two individuals, couples, that the what's vary greatly between the two individuals. And until you come together and kind of put your thoughts on paper or in a conversation, they vary very differently. Some people will say, gee, I want to keep the same amount of size I have, but maybe just go from two-story to one-story. We have a lot of couples where one spouse or partner will say, I just want to scale way down and just be able to turn the key and go and get on a cruise ship 6 months out of the year.
Yeah, and they don't want the maintenance of upkeeping a house, so they might go to something that has an association as well. But yeah, and also, if you're living in a big home, 4,000 to 5,000 square feet or larger, and you want to scale down to something that's 1,000, 1,500 square feet, that's going to be a huge lifestyle change for you because you're not used to that particular environment. So I think right now when you're planning the where and the when and you're thinking about the what, maybe even if you're looking at homes locally, look at different sizes. Go to a condo, go to a single family detached home that's 1,500 square feet, even if it's not in the location that you want it to be. And can you visualize yourself living in something that's about that size? So that's one thing that I would recommend as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And as we talk about these three W's here on the video, what we're trying to do is get the dialogue going in your household, you know, around the dining room table, sitting in the living room. Start thinking about things now before you see something, you know, that pops up on your feed on, you know, one of the search engines that you look at or whatever and says, oh my gosh, I want to buy this home. And we have that happen so many times. A client will call us and say, hey, we see this home. Let's talk about doing this. And they've done none of the background research on these three W's. And we often kind of go off half-cocked, so to speak, or that will get the dialogue going at that point in time. And we're just suggesting when you've got the luxury of time and not serious motivation to do anything right now, start the dialogue and talk about the three W's.
Well, especially if your overall monthly net nut is going to be predicated on your retirement plan, because if predictions are accurate and interest rates go up and home prices go up and all that, your overall monthly nut's going to go up and it'll affect your retirement. So if you're getting, even if you don't think that you're ready, or you think that you're two or three years down the road, have those conversations now, get the planning boards out, like you said, now run those numbers, visualize all that stuff, because if you end up being in a position where you're ready earlier than you thought, that still might save you money down the road and actually benefit your overall retirement.
Fantastic comments, Lane. So I think the closing mantra for this video is start asking yourself these questions with the significant others in your family, your immediate family, some of your extended family. Get things going now. Start a plan in place before a lifestyle factor increases you, makes you have to move.
The three W's. Remember the three W's.
Where, what, and when, in no particular order. Thanks for watching today. We hope we've given you some things to think about and some things to do to help you move to life's next chapter.
See you next week.
Bye.